They came early for their arraignment at the Sandigan Bayan. Former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, husband Mike, and former COMELEC Chairman Benjamin Abalos showed up at the anti-graft court and pleaded not guilty to charges of graft for the NBN-ZTE deal. Arroyo likewise pleaded not guilty for a similar charge for violation of the Code of Conduct for government officials. One of their co-accused, former Transportation Secretary Leandro Mendoza, will be arraigned on May 14 since he is still recuperating from a mild stroke. TV cameras were not allowed inside the 4th Division's courtroom. Arroyo's legal counsel initially tried to have her arraignment waived because of her medical condition. Attorney Jose Flaminiano told the court Arroyo has shingles. The Sandigan Bayan 4th Division, however, decided to arraign the former leader. Arroyo spoke gamely to media while waiting for her arraignment and elaborated about her shingles and her leg bandage. Arroyo's left leg is bound in kinesio tape as part of her therapy.
Now, I have to continue because I have the shingles. I'm going to have physical therapy now. I hope you've
gone
already.
Chicken pox. Oh, yes.
But you have? No, I have the shingles now. But it gets... it's contagious, but you will not get shingles. You will get chicken pox.
Yikes. I know. Maybe I had chicken pox already.
Detained at the Veterans Memorial Medical Center, Arroyo spends her days with a morning walk, physical therapy, and a mass. Doctors have prohibited her from having soda and fatty food. She receives visitors from 3 to 9 p.m.
Mass.
On a daily basis.
Mass at 7? Mm-hmm. What time?
Except that now,
yes,
ma'am. I did not go to mass yesterday. Because I've not been feeling well with the shingles. The pain is severe in shingles. It's like a very, very bad thing.
Mike Arroyo, for his part, branded the graft case another attempt to persecute the Arroyo family.
Ang gigipit lang talaga ito ng administrasyon sa amin. Hindi naman kami talaga guilty dito.
Abalos, meantime, took the opportunity to post a 30,000 peso bail for the graft case before returning to the Southern Police District headquarters, where he is detained for poll sabotage charges. The next hearing, a pre-trial conference, is set on June 4. The Arroyos and Abalos are expected to file waivers of appearance. But Mike Arroyo also told the media he plans to secure court permission to travel overseas. Still, Mike's lawyer Edna Batakan says Mike has opted to attend each and every court date so he would be aware of the proceedings. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Coming up, a survey says...